So Nehemiah, not only does he sit and weep, not only does he kneel and pray and fast, but here's the third thing. He stands up and he acts. He stands up and acts upon this desire to rebuild the walls. See, he didn't just sit back. He didn't just cry about it. He didn't just wallow in despair. He didn't just complain. He actually did something. He stood up and he acted upon it. He took a risk. And friends, listen, if we're going to see God do something in our lives over the next 21 days or over 2022, it's not enough to just sit back and complain. We have to not only pray and fast, but we have to stand up and act. We have to be obedient. We have to do what God's called us to do. We can't just sit back and just allow the enemy to continue to wreak havoc in our lives, continue to destroy the walls that God has been trying to rebuild. We have to stand up. Someone once said that the only thing necessary for the triumph of evil is for good men to do nothing. It's for good men to do nothing. And this is not a time for us to just sit back and do nothing. God has given us authority in Christ Jesus to trample upon serpents and scorpions and over all the enemy's camp. That's what Jesus told his disciples. And we have authority in the name of Jesus. And we have to use that authority to stand up and act. To do whatever it takes to see God rebuild the walls in our lives.